hey, as you can see, it's rough going out there. The roads are, I just pulled out of the gym. It's drive time, 7:03 p.m. Eastern Standard on a Monday. The 18th day of March. It's really nasty out. The roads, there's a sheet of just really, like, it's basically like crystallized ice and snow. It is the definition of a wintry mix. I don't know what's going on. It's mostly like just chunks of wet ice coated everything. And I'm sweating. I'm putting off a bunch of heat, so that's why the defroster is on, so I'll try and speak over the defroster. That's why it's a lot of shit, and it's still not even working that well, because I am really pumping out some heat. I got my gym on hard, man. Down. I got the windows open too, just a crack, just to listen to Hawk's air. This is the, I guess they salted these roads, so it got a little better. But this is the weather that I thought would come earlier. It's coming out. So what else? Did I talk about the website I bought? Yes, I did. So that's happening. Excited about that. I want to get, I have 5 really complete parts out of 40, and I have 35 started parts, but I need to get, I would say, well, I don't even need to do 5, I need to do, I could look at it this way, and every day I get at least 1 done fully, or I could do it piecemeal and try to do 5 writing, because it's multimedia, so 5 of this, 5 of that. I really should try and get like half of it done before Friday. But, you know, I feel good. Like, there's still, like, a lot of stuff that I'm never going to get to. I don't know if I'm ever going to get to creating song posts for all the songs I've ever written. I want to do that and tabulate the lyrics and kind of categorize that. You get that page with a full list of songs done. It's such a big project. I mean, the scope of it is just unreal. You create a music video for every song. It's just, it's daunting. Daunting. I'd rather just add to the mess instead of cleaning up sometimes. Sometime, someday, you know, maybe I'm selling perception of the duration of a life. Maybe I'm selling that short. Possible. There might be some time where I don't know in the foreseeable future. You know, no matter how far along. Well into the future, it could be a year from now. Circumstances might improve. I could have ample time on my hands. That'd be nice. It'd be really nice. I imagine if every day was, you know, like how I spent my Saturday. That'd be a pretty good life, and it's sad in a way that it doesn't seem like it's possible. Like, I don't understand why. Not, you know, the vast majority of people choose to do things over and over again that they don't want to do. They don't have any desire to be. They become people that they don't desire to be. They do things they don't want to do. They get themselves in situations that are not ideal, not even close to ideal. They're almost polar opposites of the situations that they would just like to be in. This is really dangerous right now. Oh yeah, oh my god. I'm like floating. I'm usually not a sissy. Totally got off my little rail there. But I'm not usually a sissy pants driver, but this is dangerous. I feel. He's coming back road now, so this hasn't been salted. It's a little weird. I made my tires. This was an easy decision not to run outside. Didn't this? Oh my god. Holy Christ. Yeah, I'm gonna go slow. I don't give a shit. Sorry, I'm not talking, but this is bad. This is really bad. Whoa. I mean, this is not, you don't want to drive on this. This is so bad. I didn't quite realize. I guess, you should. I mean, I feel I'm fine. I don't feel like anything bad's gonna happen. On them, so that's, they're bad, but I'm not, dealing with a lot of, at worst, but I'm going to collide to a tree at 5 miles per hour. Worst case scenario, I collide to a tree at 5 miles per hour. Because I'm not stupid, I'm going to try and take this fast, because, I don't want to die in a car crash. Look, people, I'm 32 years old, almost. I'm going to be 32. Oh, God, fuck my life. And, it's a month and a half. Almost exactly. Yeah. It's almost exactly a month and a half from today. I'll be 30 fucking 2 years old, man. But the only thing I can say, the only bit of knowledge I can pass on to anyone who cares to hear it, is you probably don't want to die in a car crash. I don't want to die in a car crash. An autobiography. By Vernon Howe. Pseudonym. So now I'm going to be approaching this very steep hill. Going down it. So I'm going to just not try and spiral out of control. And pump my brakes and go down the hill very slowly. I don't want to take it too slowly though, and then freak out and then screw me up and then I get, I don't know. It's probably not the best time to be doing a fake internet talk show talking about a car crash. It seems like that'd be the time, you would get into a car crash. Just passed a car, we did not collide head on. Batting 1,000, folks. Peril! The Great Night Peril! The first true perilous drive time episode. Episode 13D, huh? That before today? It did. I don't want to eat tonight. My loving parents came over to my house the other day. God rest. Oh, Jesus Christ. God bless their souls. God. And they left a bunch of food, and some of it's not the healthiest food in the world. But it's a nice gesture, right? So it's like, what do I do? I feel, I don't want to throw it out, but I've been trying to eat healthy, and I have all these kind of potatoes, so I'm trying to limit my carb intake. I think what I'm going to do is create a salad. This is riveting, isn't it? Be talking about what I'm possibly going to eat tonight as I maneuver through a wintry mix. I thought so. They gave me chicken parm, which I had for lunch, and I have another big piece. I think I'm going to strip off the breading and the cheese and the sauce and repurpose it by grilling it again and adding it to the salad. How about that? And I made a little bit of potato salad. That could be like a carb. I ate some at lunch and then I ate some at night. It's about spacing. I'm not against carbs. I'm very pro carbs. But, you gotta balance it out. Any idiot who says they don't understand how the food system works, I don't know the science behind it. You don't need to know the science behind it. You know, you just know that French fries, just the way they feel, is just when you swallow them. Right? Like, so people are like, I don't know, man. Oh, eat this, or, you know, this is what I like to eat. It's all carb stuff, right? Which is fine, do what you want. But I don't understand why anyone who's not mentally, handicapped or challenged, you know, truly mentally deficient, how they don't understand how that works. I just feel like it's ingrained in us to know that, you know, if you're not getting any exercise, for instance, someone, and then you're putting in a bunch of junk food, you can feel that in your body. You can. I've been, you know, I've put on weight before. I can feel it myself getting fat. I mean, it's totally a decision, and it's these people who you know, say that it's not, and it is an addiction. I'm not saying it's not. That's not a part of it. It certainly is. So I sympathize, but I think to cover it up, sometimes people use this excuse they don't understand how the science behind food works, and they don't have to. And my point is, they don't have to understand the science behind it. Like, they don't have to understand, you know, how we break down proteins and carbo, you know, that kind of real sciencey stuff. They know. What the fuck? Where did that tangent come from? Oh man, I survived, and I'm gonna eat carbs. Hopefully my dog will go to the bathroom in this weather. My dog hates the bad weather. He's a little pussy. He's so cute though.